Today we have Dr. Ballan, the medical director over at White Glove Health, joining us today. Thanks for joining us today, Dr. Ballan.
You bet.
White Glove is a mobile healthcare company. You guys are based out of Texas, but are growing all over the nation and growing really, really fast. You guys have over 200 different nurse practitioners within your network providing care in all sorts of different mobile facilities, at work, nursing facilities, all over the place. Yeah, I just wanted to learn a little bit more about what White Glove services are.
Okay, the whole idea came out of the idea that people are basically better taken care of at home. And there's no way to do that unless you have a good system for providing patients with what they used to have in the doctor's office. Of course, in the doctor's office, people would have a bunch of equipment that we're able to carry now, thanks to technology. But the one thing that was really hard was the medical record, because we have mobile providers, so we have different people perhaps seeing the same patient. They all have to be on the same page. They all have to be able to read what's going on. And patients don't like it if you don't remember them.
Absolutely.
If you don't have enough information. So it's very important to have a good electronic record. I don't think anybody can really follow any of the out-of-the-box medical records because they don't fit with what you do necessarily. We have a number of lines of business, some where we visit new mothers in their homes, others where we visit sick children, others where we see older patients either in the nursing home or in their homes. And so we needed a flexible system that we were able to basically customize without pulling up somebody at the plan, at the EHR and say, hi, we're back, we want some more changes. So the Chrono system is actually very good in that it allows us to customize it ourselves.
Great. So going into how you guys are running White Glove, what makes you guys different than a lot of other vendors out there?
I think this is a growing business. There are a number of different people providing the services. One of the special things about us is our employees are all employees. These are not contractors that we're subcontracting out. So we have direct abilities to make sure that they're doing the right thing. We are able to provide the oversight for them.
Great. And you guys are leading the industry in how value-based care is being delivered for these chronic patients and a lot of the Medicaid and Medicare patients. What are some things that you guys are doing to really make that transition to value-based care?
Well, the important thing with value-based care is understanding where it came from. It was for many, many years where we would see a doctor and the doctor would take care of us for what was wrong and get paid based on how wrong it was, which wasn't really a system for improving the overall health. In other words, it was incentivized so that maybe people are not necessarily getting healthier. So value-based care, the idea behind it is we are incentivized to make people better. And we've been very successful at it because we're reaching people that wouldn't normally get the care. For whatever reason, they're not making that leap from their comfort zone to a doctor's office or to another place where doctors are. So that is, I think, one of the chief things that we do, and we do it well. We use experienced clinicians who are able to make people feel at ease. It takes a special type of person to go into the home, and you learn so much just in a few minutes in somebody's home compared with seeing them in an office and asking them a bunch of questions. It's all right there for you in the home. We're delighted to be able to provide care there.
Okay, do you mind actually walking us through what a typical patient encounter is like for White Glove?
Well, that's kind of the fun thing. There really is no typical encounter, but let's pretend we have a person who has a number of chronic illnesses and we're visiting with them for the first time. So one of the first things we have to do is find out what's happened to them in the past. What is their past history? And we try and gather as much information as we can from them. But again, the home is a good source of information. So we're able to see what medications they have. And certainly they could carry their medications to a doctor's office in a shopping bag. But here we can see which ones are out, which ones are hidden in the cabinet, which ones are by the nightstand, which ones are full, which ones are empty. And we get a much better idea of what might be wrong with a person, even if they can't tell us. Once that's done, and we know what's happened in the past, then we're able to take a look at what's going on now. So we do what's called a history and a physical. History is where we find out what's been going on so far, and the physical is where we take a look at a person in general. And then we can order other testing if necessary to find out what needs to happen next for that person. We can also contract to have other services go to the home. Now, of course, there are certain things that can't be done in the home, but at least we can make it easier for them to get those things done rather than have to make the phone calls and self-refer.
So when it comes to these high-cost, high-risk patients, is there anything you guys are doing differently compared to other doctors' offices?
Yeah, I think that certainly by being in the home, we're meeting with the more challenging members, people who don't have it where they can just hop in the car, make an appointment, and go see the doctor. So you're really talking about a fairly impaired population. I don't think that those folks even get to see a doctor in their office all that often. In fact, they end up in the emergency department and in the hospital where they get a fragmented care compared to a comprehensive care that we can offer.
Absolutely. That's so important to have. So Dr. Ballan, just switching gears a little bit, what got you to White Glove? What made you interested in working at this type of a company?
I had started my own home visit practice, and my problem was it wasn't scalable. It was just me. I was going from house to house. And White Glove has an infrastructure. They have an organization that allows for expansion. They're able to contract with managed care companies, and they have a track record of bringing costs down. And so we're sought after for that reason, and we are continually busy for that reason, and that's why we continue to expand.
We mentioned briefly you guys' use of the DrChrono EHR system. What drove you guys to choose our system over any other system out there?
We had started our company with a proprietary electronic record, and it wasn't meeting our needs, even though it was created at White Glove. And so, looking at a bunch of different systems, this is probably the eighth electronic record that I've worked with. This is by far one of the best ones to use because you're able to customize it.
Okay, great. I know that your engineers over there are working with us on our API very intimately. What are some customizations you've made to DrChrono that have really fitted towards the White Glove?
When we have a new type of patient to see, we're able to get together with the health plan and say, what is the data that you'd like us to collect? How can we forward your cause better? And certainly we can give a big long course to our clinicians and say, look, this is what this plan needs. This is why they need it. We want you to do it. Or we can simply put those in a template, build a brand new template that includes that information, and say, make sure you hit this template, and then the template drives the information gathering. So we're not actually telling people, don't forget this and don't forget that. The computer does it for them.
Oh, fantastic. So you're talking about some of these plans that you guys are working with. Are they like ACOs? Are they the large health plans like Aetna? Who are these plans?
We're working with Amerigroup. as one, and also Johns Hopkins. We're working on a contract with them. It's almost finished. We have talks with Empire Blue Cross that we're working with as well. So these are big plans. We have smaller plans as well. And we also work with corporations in keeping their members healthy.
Okay, great, great. So I guess we've pretty much hit our time block right here. Thanks so much for joining me today, Dr. Ballan, and have a great day.
Oh, you bet.